r/ProRevenge. Cancel me leave. Say goodbye to your promotion. Story by Scott 3496. Enjoy. I used to work in a disability shared accommodation agency. It's a job where you support 4 to 6 people with disabilities who share the accommodation. It's shift work, 2 clients per staff member during the day, 1 staff member on a sleepover at night. The rosters are 4-week rotating rosters. I was employed as a 0.75, meaning I work 75% of what is considered full-time, equating to 57 hours a fortnight. Working shifts sucked, but the pay was good. I was working in a house all call sunup. Sunup had 4 residents and 7 workers. Each house had a house supervisor. They reported to the cluster manager, who managed 6 houses. Cluster managers reports to the CEO. By company policy, leave requests are first in best dressed, meaning you need to put your leave in early to ensure you get it. I was transferred to sunup from a 6 client house due to my qualifications and situations I cannot legally disclose. I worked for the first year, got to know staff, clients, house supervisor, etc. There was an obvious clique between 4 staff members. Each school holidays, 3 would apply for leave, and 1 would call in sick with a medical certificate covering the same amount of time. They would always rotate who is sick to hide what they were up to. They were friends outside of work who would party together. After a year, the house supervisor fell sick. One of the clique members, Karen, was appointment acting supervisor and it went to hell. She tried reducing my hours and giving extra time to a friend. I pointed out that I'm contracted for 57 hours a fortnight, so I'm getting paid for 57 hours a fortnight. Her friends got extra shifts. We're given the best shifts and were all around favored by Karen. In January, I put in leave for March school holidays. Karen rejected on the grounds that others had already submitted leave. Her clique all applied for this time. I left this alone. In March, I checked the leave calendar for the June school holidays. Each house had a leave calendar so management and staff can check who scheduled leave as it was empty. I submitted leave again and it was rejected. Karen said, "Sorry, you were too slow." Karen said that A, B and C clique already submitted leave. The next day the leave calendar showed this. In May, I checked Xmas leave calendar, put in my leave and sure enough, got the same result. This annoyed me as I have a family that I wanted to take on holiday. I spoke to the cluster manager, also a part of the clique, who said there's nothing I can do. Note, I had no leave taken in 2 years. January the following year, the clique was on holiday. We had a gastro outbreak across our facilities, so we were short staff. All available staff, including CEO, were covering shifts. I was rostered on with the CEO 1 shift. During the shift he said to me, "Op, you have a bit of leave accumulated. You should probably take some." Me, I put in 3 requests last year. All were rejected as others apparently already applied for those dates. CEO, "Let's lock in your leave now." Me, "Okay, how about 4 weeks over Xmas?" I filled out the form, CEO signed it off. He filled out the leave calendar and put my application in Karen's pigeonhole. I was on sleep over that night, so I took my application, photocopied it for myself and replaced under the mountain of paperwork in her pigeonhole, knowing she wouldn't see it for a few months. In March I checked the leave calendar. I noticed my Xmas leave disappeared, replaced with Karen, A, B and C. I didn't say anything as I had a leave form with CEO's signature. Fast forward October, original house supervisor passed away, acting supervisor was appointed permanent supervisor by the cluster manager with a mandatory 3-month probation. December comes around, first week of my leave, I get a call from Karen. "Where are you?" "Me, on leave." "Karen, I didn't approve any leave. Get your ass to work now." I come in, Karen chews me out stating she didn't get an application form. Karen went on to sow, "Even if you submitted it I would reject it, as you should know by now that we always take 2 weeks in December, January." She wrote me up for insubordination. I worked that shift. When Karen left I emailed the CEO filling him in on what happened. He called a meeting me and Karen. "CEO, what happened?" "Karen cutting me off." "Op took it upon himself to approve leave. I wrote him up for skipping work." "Me, actually I submitted leave in January, while you were away." "Karen, no you didn't." "CEO, yes he did. I approved it and added it to the leave calendar." "Karen, oh, we already had 4 staff booked on leave." "CEO, show me the leave forms." "Karen, I destroyed them." "Me handing Karen my copy of my form signed by the CEO. CEO, op is on leave. I'm going to SunUp and I'm investigating this situation. Op, my apologies. Go home. I'm extending your leave by an extra week. I go home. I come in 4-5 weeks later to be told that Karen has lost her promotion. She is thin ice. CEO found out that Karen has been rejecting leave requests. She shredded my request without looking past the date. She deleted my leave from the calendar. The CEO told Karen that this borders on fraud. The CEO also separated the clique to different houses. He changed the leave policy to state that he must sign off leave requests in addition to house supervisor and cluster managers. He ensured that all staff had access to prime leave dates. Karen was fired 2 weeks later for failing audit requirements. Brilliant. Loved reading this. I cannot handle conspiring coworkers. I'm super glad you ended up getting what you deserved, smiley face. Thanks, wasn't my intention to cost her her promotion. But it was an excellent outcome. Bad karma is like a boomerang of schlongs. It always comes back around to f*** ya. This is now one of my favorite sentences. That's a good CEO there. She committed fraud. They all did, and they all should be fired. I can't imagine any other scenario where these people were falsifying records and taking their holidays at the same time every year like clockwork ahead of everyone else. They all rigged the system. Whether they falsified the documents or benefited from them year after year, they were all knowingly part of this fraudulent scheme and must suffer some consequences as a result. If not firing, then demotion to the most junior station. That would be suitably humiliating to them, and just might cause them to quit. Clique. Who the hell goes into social work type fields and is that awful? I'm not saying you have to be a wannabe superhero, but good lord awful person. After reading the title, I was hoping this was a story about pirates. Sorry you had to put up with it for so long, but Karen and the clique got what was coming to them. You are strong, my friend. Just f***ing desserts. You are an absolute legend for making it to the end. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, please hit that like button. And if you can't get enough, consider subscribing. See you around.